and even provided handsomely for his housekeeper, I understand.
All right, all right. So, like any criminal, he wanted to move on before somebody traced his whereabouts.
He specifically requested passage on a vessel that was scheduled to stop here, at a Bajoran station. Rather unusual request for a Cardassian war criminal.
Unless he wanted to be captured.
Wait a minute. Let's be clear about one thing. This evidence may raise some interesting questions. Nevertheless, Darheel is going to be sent back to Bajor to stand trial for the atrocities he committed.
Major, that is still to be determined.
Then go talk to him. If you still have any doubts, listen to what he has to say. He was there. He did it. He'll tell you about it.
Constable, I've checked on Maritza's medical record.
What have we got?
He's under treatment for Kalanora syndrome, of course, and a few other minor ailments, most relating to his age. It's all pretty standard, really, except for one thing.
Which is?
5 years ago, after arriving on Kora 2, he started taking massive doses of dermateralian plasticine, which is a dermal regenerative agent used to maintain skin resilience after cosmetic alteration.
You're saying he changed his face to look like Guldar Heel?
Certainly appears that way.
How are you feeling?
I was starting to get a little bored, but seeing you again brightens my day.
I was referring to your Kalanora syndrome. Would you like to see Dr. Bashir?
Oh, so that's it. You want to see me writhing around the floor in pain. Cardassian would never put on such a deplorable display in front of a Bajoran. You just don't understand us at all.
Beginning to understand a great deal about you. One thing does puzzle me.
And what would that be?
How you contracted Kalanora syndrome.
Do you think that the mining accident affected only the Bajoran laborers and not their Cardassian masters? That would be very nice.
So you're saying you were at Galatep when that mining accident occurred?
Of course! Why are we going over this again?
Because your own progress report shows you were back on Cardassia at the time of the accident.
That's ridiculous.
Receiving your proficient service medallion.
The reports are wrong.
I can show them to you.
That won't be necessary. I know where I was.
Why were you taking a dermal regenerative?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Then let me help you. 5 years ago. When you first got to Kora 2.
All right, that's enough. Your presence no longer amuses me. Get out.
Why did you have your face altered?
Security, get this woman out of here.
Why are you pretending to be Guldar Heel?
Why don't you ask me something intelligent? As for instance, how did I feel when we were withdrawing from Bajor? The answer is I was furious. The thought of leaving any survivors behind was repulsive to me. So while our useless office clerks were packing their precious files, I ordered my overseers to begin slaughtering the laborers.
If you felt that way about your filing clerks, why did you take Maritza's name?
My plan was to do nothing less than kill every Bajoran in the camp. And to this day, my one regret is that I was not able to accomplish this honorable goal.
You're Maritza, aren't you?
You mistake me for that bug. That whimpering nothing. Oh, you stupid Bajoran girl, don't you know who I am? I'm your nemesis. I'm your nightmare. I'm the Butcher of Galatep.
The Butcher of Galatep died 6 years ago. You're Eamon Maritza, his filing clerk.
That's not true. I am alive. I'll always be alive. It's Maritza who's dead. Maritza, who was good for nothing but cowering under his bunk and weeping like a woman. Who every night covered his ears because he couldn't bear to hear the screaming for mercy of the Bajorans.